dear friends, today I am going to teach you the second chapter of chemistry, that is matter around us pure? Before starting the lesson, I need to ask you that how do we judge whether the milk, ghee and salts are the pure substances? For the common people, pure substances means having no adulteration. But for the scientists, these all things are not a pure substances. These are the mixture of two or more substances. For example, milk. Milk is a mixture of water, fats and proteins. Then what is mixture? Let us learn about the mixture. Mixture is constituted by more than one kind of pure form of matter. Take example, sodium chloride solution. It is a mixture of water. We can separate it, sodium chloride and water, by the physical process like evaporation. Takes only the sodium chloride. We cannot separate it like sodium and chlorine by the physical process. Now let us learn about the types of mixture. We already learned in the previous class that there are two types of mixture. One is homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture means it is uniformly composed. Heterogeneous mixture means it is non-uniformly composed. Heterogeneous mixture we can separate easily when compared to the homogeneous mixture. For example, see, this is the mixture, homogeneous mixture. It is a mixture of water and the salt. It is heterogeneous mixture. It is the mixture of wheat and the rice. I cannot separate this homogeneous mixture, but I can separate this heterogeneous mixture easily when compared to this homogeneous mixture. Now let us learn about the solution. Then what is solution? The homogeneous mixture of two or more substances is called solution. Commonly we think that the solution is only in the liquid form. But it's wrong. It either in the solid form or in the gaseous form or in the liquid form. For example, jewels. Jewels is a mixture of copper and the gold. It is in the solid form. And the example for the gaseous form, that is air. Now solution has two component, that is solvent and the solution. Solvent means the substance which dissolves the solute in it, means other substance in it, that is solvent. Then solute means the substance which is going to be dissolved itself in the other substance. For example, this is water and this is sugar. This water is a solute and water is a solvent and sugar is a solute. Because this water dissolves the other substance, means like sugar, in it. So it is the solvent. Sugar is a solute. It is itself going to be dissolved in the water. Thank you.
Good afternoon everyone. Today I am going to teach you about natural resources. Already we have studied about natural resources in our previous classes. But now I am going to teach you some more points about natural resources. Earth is our living planet. Earth is the only planet where life is existed. It is dependent on many factors. The resources available on the Earth and the energy from the sun are necessary to meet the basic requirements of all the life forms on the Earth. What are these resources on the Earth? These are the land, water and the air. The outer crust of the Earth is called as lithosphere. Water covers 75% of the Earth's surface and it is known as hydrosphere. And the Earth is covered by air like a blanket and it is known as atmosphere. Living things are found where these three are existed. The life supporting zone of the Earth where atmosphere, hydrosphere and lithosphere interact and make life possible and it is known as biosphere. Now let us study about the breath of life, which means air. Air is nothing but it is a mixture of many gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide and water vapor. Mars and Venus, the major component of atmosphere is found to be carbon dioxide. Eukaryotic cells and prokaryotic cells need oxygen to break down the glucose molecules and to get the energy for their activities. These are the results of production of carbon dioxide. Thank you.
Hi, glorious evening to everybody. Today let us move on the topic motion. So we have learned about the motion in previous classes. Is it right?
Yes.
So let's recall it. What do you mean by motion? Motion is nothing but changing position according to the time or according to the situation. For example, the moving person, the moving car, and the moving blades of the fan. And we can say motion is also a relative term, because motion is an object is always with respect of frame of reference. Like a boy or a person along with two kids standing at bus stop and waiting for the bus. So what do you think? So are they in motion or they are in rest? Of course, they are not in motion. They are in rest because they are not showing any action. They are only a position. They are not showing any action. So we can say they are in rest. Action like jumping, swimming, running, etc. They are not doing anything at all. So we can say they are in only in rest. And motion is also known as any object is showing its action is also called as a motion. Like a bus is passing by across the road. Is a bus is in motion? Yes, of course bus is in motion because bus is showing its action. How the bus is moving from one point to another. It is motion and it is showing its action. So we can say bus is in motion. Another one, like in bus, two members are sitting, A and B. For B, A is in rest or A is in motion. These are the two confusion for the B. But the fact is, A is not in motion. A is in rest. Only the bus is in motion. Only the bus is moving. But we are not moving. A is not moving. Only the bus is moving. So, for A, B is in rest. And for B, A is in rest. For example, I already told you, a person with two kids. For example, if the bus is moving, we are sitting inside. For him, how can he think, we are also moving and the bus is also moving. But the fact is, we are in the rest and the bus is moving. So, we can conclude. Any object is in rest, is in motion or is in rest, it is depend upon only the person. Thank you.
Good afternoon, my dear friends. Today I am going to explain you about 9th standard second syllabus of second chapter science. Is matter around us pure? Do you know, is matter around us pure? Can you able to see, is there any purity sign on the milk packet or ghee or juice in anything of this packet when you purchase from the retailer shops? I will show you once again. See, in this milk packet, is there any kind of purity sign? No. But people will think this is the sign of purity and they think if there is no adulteration, they think it is the good for them. But scientists will think it is not good for them. It is full of mix. It contains mixture of water, fats and proteins, etc. But people will think it is a pure. But scientists will say it is a mixture of some food items. And if scientists want to say it is full of pure, then all particles of substance are same in their chemical ratios. Is 5:6 ratios will be there, that all should be same in equal level. They say that substance consists of single types of particles. The scientist will say there will be one kind of particles, and we all can call it a substance also. We can call it as particles and substance too. It is a pure single form of matter. Example, sugar. In sugar, all the ratios will be same and molecules will be same. If we look around in our surroundings, we can see some of exist with two or more pure elements. Example, seawater, minerals, soil, etc. I will repeat once again. Seawater, minerals, soils, etc. And okay friends, I have explained about introduction. Do you know what is mixture? It's okay, I will say this mixture. These are constituted by more than one kind of pure matter, and we can call it as substance also. We can call it as pure matter and substance also. And these substance cannot be separated by physical progress. It need chemical progress. Physical progress means if we keep outside this chemicals, means it will not separate. And we know that dissolved sodium chloride can be separated by evaporation. You can see near the seasides, they have collected seawater and they'll keep in sunshine. It will evaporate the water and the salt will remain after 1 week or 2 weeks. Like this, we can call it as physical progress of changing. And however, sodium chloride is one of the substance, it is only one. It cannot be separated by physical changing. It want to be conducted chemical change in the labs. Sugar is substance because it contains only one kind of pure matter and its composition is same. Means all the molecules in the sugar will be same. It don't have difference because it is sweet. No, it don't have difference. Soft drink and soil are not single substance because soft drink contains sodium chloride and other kinds of acids, and it contains everything in soft drink and soil. Whatever the source of substance may be, it will always have the same characteristic properties. Other kinds of juices and everything has other kinds of acids and other kind of chemical properties. Even everything is also did by chemical properties. And what I have explained, it help you to understand that mixture contains two or more pure properties. And we can call it
Christianity and Islam. We already know there are many religions like Christianity, Islam, Hinduism and so on. Like Buddhism, Jainism, Hindus, Christianity, Islam. These religions have been developed in the various BCE. Let's note up this point. What is the full form of the BCE? B, before. C, common. E, era. Before common era. These religions have been developed in the various BCE and spread across the world. Those religions have been spread across the world, like Christianity and the Islam. These religions have been developed in the 1st century BCE, before common era. These religions have been, like Christianity and Islam, have been developed in the 1st century BCE. And these religions have become the major world religions. These religions have become the major world religions also. These religions, which Christianity and Islam, which became the major world religions. These religions are known as the Semitic religions. And the next, the people who are living in the Middle East. What is this? The people who are living in the Middle East. Those peoples are known as the Semitic races. Okay? Who are called as Semitic religions? The people who are the Christianity and the Islam, which these religions have become the major world religions, they are called as the Semitic religions. And the people who are living in the Middle East also known as the Semitic races. Especially these two religions, which are those religions, Christianity and the Islam. Especially these two religions have been spread across the different parts of the world. These religions have been spread across the different parts of the world and became the major world religions, like Muslims and the Pakistan. Is it? In this earth, in this India also, there are many many Muslims also living here. These Muslims have spread across the Pakistan also. Okay, this first point is finished. Next point is the Christianity's full details. I will explain you that details in the next seminar. Okay, thank you.
My dear friends, today let us learn about the number system in mathematics. It will come in 9th standard syllabus. Now, let us study about number system. In number system, there are natural numbers, whole numbers, integer numbers, rational numbers, irrational numbers, real numbers. In our previous classes, we have learned about the how to represent the numbers and how to represent the numbers in number line. All these things we have learned in our previous classes. Now, let us learn about natural numbers. Counting numbers are called natural numbers. Examples 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And it is denoted by n. Now, let us study about whole numbers. Counting numbers with 0 is called whole numbers. And it is denoted by 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And now let's study about integer number. Negative numbers with 0 with positive numbers is called integer number. And now let's study about rational number. If it is in the form of P by Q form, where P and Q are integer, where Q not equal to 0 is called rational number. Now let us study about irrational number. If it is not in the form of P by Q form, where P and Q are integer, where Q not equal to 0 is called irrational number. Now let us study about real number. Set of all rational number and irrational number is called real number. And irrational number is the founder of Pythagoras. Pythagoras is a Greek mathematician and philosopher. Thank you.